Hi, this is Justin from the Greater Nanticoke Area School District, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to access your child's GNASD.com assigned email address. Start by opening up your preferred web browser. In our case, we like to use Google Chrome, and just do a Google search for GNASD. And we should be the top link that appears, and you can click us there. And if you notice, all we did was went to GNASD.com. If you're a little bit more of an advanced user, feel free to type in GNASD.com up here in the URL bar and get right to this step here. Okay, so we are going to start by hovering over, but not clicking, the Departments tab. And then we're going to hover over Technology. And then we're going to find this link here that says GNA Email. Please click that. And if done correctly, you will see our Outlook login page with our Nanticoke Area Trojans logo here. This is where you'll enter your son or daughter's email address that they've been assigned to by the school district. If you do not know that email address or do not know the temporary password for that email address, please contact your teachers. And if they do not know it, you can also reach out to helpdesk@gnasd.com for that information. So in our case, we have a testing student here that we've set up to show you how to use this. His name is John Smith. So we're going to sign into his account, which is C28SmithJ@GNASD.com. I click Next. And then you're going to have that temporary password that I briefly mentioned, given to you by the school district. Your teacher should have that, and if they don't, you can also contact Help Desk for that information. And then we'll click Sign In. And if done correctly, you should see an Update Your Password field if this is the first time logging into your student's account. You will have to enter the current password, which is that temporary password that we've been discussing. And then you're going to have to select a new password. I'm going to enter a password here. And as long as the password meets the complexity requirements and the length requirements, it has to have at least 8 digits, uppercase letters, lowercase letters, and a number thrown in there. Then you'll click Sign In. And if the password is secure enough, you will then be taken to the More Information Required screen. And this is basically a bunch of questions that it will ask you so you can reset your own password should you forget it in the future. So we are going to click Next. And as you can see here, it doesn't want you to lose access to your account. To make sure you can reset your password, we need to collect some info so we can verify who you are. You don't have to set up all three of these. You just have to pick one. In our case, we will do some security questions. And then you have to set up 5 security questions for the security question option. If you want, you can just simply enter your son or daughter's phone number or your cell phone number. We won't use this to contact you for anything. The only reason it would be used is if you click I forgot my password, it'll send you a one-time temporary password to your cell phone to get back into your child's account here. Same thing with authentication email. We won't collect this and send you marketing or anything like that. This is just to send you a temporary password in the event that you lose your original password. And as I said before, we are going to, for our purposes, set up security questions and just click on the button that says set them up now. So as we said before, we have 5 security questions here. I'm just going to pick a couple generic ones and fill them in. We love pizza. Father's middle name, John. Mother's middle name, we'll say Sue. Youngest sibling's middle name, Mary. And we'll do name of the street of your first childhood home. We'll say Hanover. Now, obviously, set these up to be your answers and your questions, and make sure that you'll be able to answer these questions if they are asked for resetting your password purposes. Then once you have all this information typed in, you can click Save those answers. And you will get a check mark on the one that you've set up. Again, if you choose to set up one of these other options, you would get the check mark up there. And then just click Finish. And the first time your child logs into the account, it'll take a couple seconds there, as you've noticed, to finish setting up the account. And then you will get the welcome screen where it will show you some features and how to use the email system. And then you can click Get Started. And if we had any emails coming into this account, we would see them right here. Okay, that was a brief introduction on how to sign in and set up your tognasd.com email address. Thank you.